ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا
tawbah or repentance is not one saying, I repent to Allah, or oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive me. While at the same time, one insists on sin, being careless about the sin that he has committed, or intends to go against Allah's commandments. O people, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it is too late, when the doors of tawbah, of repentance, are shut before you. Allah keeps the doors of repentance open for man until the time of his death, when his soul reaches the throat upon separation from the body, after which his penance will not be accepted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَهَالَةٍ ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ فَأُولَئِكَ يَتُوبُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات حتى إذا حضر أحدهم الموت قال إني تبت الآن ولا الذين يموتون وهم كفار أولئك أعتدنا لهم عذابا أليما. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, Allah accepts only the repentance, only the tawbah of those who do evil in ignorance and foolishness and repent soon afterwards. It is they whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive, and Allah is ever all knowing, all wise. And of no effect, of no use, is the repentance of those who continue to do evil until death faces one of them and he says, now I repent. Nor of those who die while they are kuffar, disbelievers, for them we have prepared a painful turmoil. Brothers and sisters in Islam, rush to repentance, rush to tawbah, for you do not know when you will be surprised by death or the chastisement of the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أَفَأَمِنَ أَهْلُ الْقُرَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا بَيَاتٍ وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ أَوَأَمِنَ أَهْلُ الْقُرَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا ضُحًى وَهُمْ يَلْعَبُونَ أَفَأَمِنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ فَلَا يَأْمَنُ مَكْرَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran, did the people of the towns then feel secure, feel safe against the coming of our punishment by night while they were asleep? Or did they, the people of the town, feel secure against the coming of our punishment in the forenoon while they were playing? Did they then feel secure against the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? None feel secure from the plan of Allah except those people who are losers. Ibadallah, O servants of Allah, do you feel secure that you can escape the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while He bestows His favors upon you? You continue to be rebellious and disobedient. Do you not notice the world around you? And what happened to those who kept sinning until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afflicted them with hardship and tribulations in their life? Many parts of the world have been afflicted with famine, floods, and the lack of crops and rain. Yet the thinkers and intellectuals of the world are trying to study the options of food provision for the world's population. Does this not deter you from the decision in Islam? Certainly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respites the oppressor until when it is time He seizes him with a firm grip. Allah said in the Quran, وَكَذَلِكَ أَخْذُ رَبِّكَ إِذَا أَخْذَ الْقُرَى وَهِيَ ظَالِمَةٌ إِنَّ أَخْذَهُ أَلِيمٌ شَدِيدٌ. Such is the seizure of your Rabb. When he seizes the populations of towns while they are doing wrong. Indeed, his seizure is painful and severe. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the worst punishment in this life is the hardness of heart. Many people have hard hearts these days. Yes. They hear the admonishing advices and read the admonishing and impressive ayat in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yet they do not listen and their hearts are not even touched. The best among them would only be touched just at the moment of listening and understanding such admonishment. But after a while, the impact recedes and heedlessness prevails again. Then they are back again to business as usual. For instance, they can hear the warning against those who do not pray. Or if they pray, they are careless about their prayers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيًّا إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, then there has succeeded them a prosperity who have given up a salah, a prayer. That is, made their salah to be lost, either by not offering them or by not offering them perfectly or by not offering them in the proper fixed times. And instead have followed their lusts, their desires. So they will be thrown in hellfire. Except those who repent, those who commit tawbah. Yet they do not repent, just as they have never heard anything to that effect. They will hear the ayat warning those who fail to pay their zakat. Or if they do pay it, they pay with the worst of their money. They hear about the punishment, yes. But even then, they do not respond. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. And woe to al-mushrikun, the polytheists, idolaters, disbelievers in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who do not give the zakat. They do not perform the zakat of the soul, which is intended to purify it from shirk, taking partners with Allah in worship. They also do not perform the zakat of their wealth, and they follow their whims instead of obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in giving away charity from part of the wealth that is dear to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَيَمَّمُوا الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ تُنْفِقُونَ وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِيهِ إِلَّا أَنْ تُغْمِضُوا فِيهِ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ. And do not aim at that which is bad to spend them for. Though you will not accept it, save if you close your eyes and tolerate therein. And know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ghani, is rich, free of all needs, and worthy of all praise. They hear all that, and yet they insist on our paying their zakat. By this they deprive themselves from the blessings of their wealth and save it for others, that is for their heirs. One hadith states that when the people spread sins and corruption in their society, they will be affected with diseases and illnesses which were unknown to their predecessors. When they tamper with the scale used in weighing goods for people, they will be subjected to famine, loss of provision, and oppression of the rulers. When they cease to pay their zakat dues, they will be afflicted with the lack of rain. And if it were not for the sake of animals, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not send them any rain. When they breach their pledges to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Sunnah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah will cause an enemy that is not from them to overpower them and take some of what is in what is in their possession. When the rulers and the imam cease to be to govern, by the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will cause them to use their strength against each other. Yes, although they hear the commandment of Allah regarding the false testament, they still practice it as if they had not heard it or understood what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ruled concerning. In this regard, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله ورسوله ولا تولوا عنه وأنتم تسمعون. O you who believe, obey Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and turn not away from Him, that is the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, while you are here. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayat wa dhikr al-hakim. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwa al-ghafur ar-rahim. الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه أما بعد. O people, there shall be no penance accepted if the one repenting still insists on doing the same sin. How can someone repent for cheating in his business transaction when he is at the same time willing to cheat again? How can someone repent for backbiting while still involved in it and willing to do it every chance he or she has? How could he repent for usurping people's money and property while at the same time still doing so? Either by claiming what is not his, denying people's rights to their own property, lying in his bargains with them, staying on someone's property without his consent, or by using riba, usury, interest in his dealing with the people. In regards to this, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ كَانَ لِأَخِيهِ عِنَهُ مَظْلَمَةٌ مِنْ مَالٍ أَوْ عِرْضٍ فَلْيَتَحَلَّلْهُ الْيَوْمَ قَبْلَ أَنْ لَا يَكُونَ دِينَارٌ أَوْ دِرْهَمٌ إِلَّا الْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he who owes his brother something or has wronged him should reconcile with him and pay his debt today before there is no dirham or dinar on the Day of Judgment. Paying will only be with the good deeds and the taking of the bad deeds. For Muslims, as tawbah, repentance entails renouncing and regretting the sin and determining to never come back to it again. It also includes intending to do the obligations as much as possible. By this, the person becomes truly penitent and deserving of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For he says, truly Allah loves those who turn to Him in repentance and loves those who purify themselves. Inna Allah wa yuhibbu at-tawwabeena wa yuhibbu al-mutatahhirin. O Muslims, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and beg Him to forgive you by seeking His forgiveness with your speech as well as from your hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, and all of you beg Allah to forgive you all, O believers, that you may be successful. Rush to repentance before you reach your set time to die. Thereafter you will never be given another chance to repent, and you will therefore die as a sinner. Some people are deceived by their hopes or by shaitan, and hence keep putting off tawbah until their hearts become hard as rocks because of the sins that they insist on. Until the doors of repentance are no longer open, or until death surprises them, then it will be too late to repent or make amends. عباد الله, إن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي نبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. ألا وصلوا على من أمركم ربكم بالصلاة عليه فقال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد ورضي الله عنا عن أربعة الخلفاء الأئمة الخلفاء أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن بقية الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين وتابعيهم. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا صفاء وصفاء وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها. اللهم انصر عبادك المجاهدين في كل مكان. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. واجعلنا من الذين تجري من تحتهم الأنهار في جنات النعيم. دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحيتهم فيها سلام. وآخر دعواهم الحمد لله رب العالمين.